Hi there, Doug Stuman with IT Creations with one of Dell's super-duper servers, the Dell EMC PowerEdge XE8545 server. As Dell says, this for-you platform offers AI infrastructure without compromise. It's designed for artificial intelligence, machine learning, not to mention inference, analytics, and a host of other high-performance computing applications. It's powered by dual third-generation AMD EPYC Milan processors with up to 64 Zen 3 cores each, and supports four Nvidia SMX4 A100 GPUs with NVLink technology. Back in the day, and by that I mean like 2 years ago, this was a CRN's 2021 Product of the Year recipient. I mean, aside from this channel, CRN is the number one trusted source for IT channel news, analysis, and insight. Pretty impressive. I will mention there is actually an Intel-based version of this same system, but that one is the XE9680. Aside from the AI computing, machine learning, and inference, it can also be used for multi-tenant environments with virtualization. Those A100 GPUs supported on this platform can be segmented to provide multiple instances for multiple users. The multi-tenant and virtualization options are embedded in the GPU architecture with MIG support, or multi-instance GPU capability, and NVIDIA's virtual GPU software, providing a flexible set of virtualization options. Pretty slick, or should I say sick, and by that I mean in a good way. For such a high-performance platform, the system still has a standard rack depth paired with air cooling to easily integrate with your existing infrastructure. The front bezel has a lock and optional LCD panel. Once removed, there are 10 2.5-inch storage bays supporting a universal backplane. The system can be configured with SAS and SATA drive types. An alternate configuration includes up to 8 U.2 NVMe SSDs with 8 PCIe NVMe connectors on the system board. Utilizing NVMe drives reduces latency and keeps data close to the CPU when dealing with large data sets. A row of 12 hot swap GPU fans are just below the drive bays. Are you interested in taking your AI, machine learning, and in general high-performance computing needs to the next level? For a limited time, you can save up to $500 off the Dell EMC PowerEdge XE8545 GPU server that's listed on our site, or one that you can configure that's valued at $5,000 or more. How? It's simple. Just mention this video to a sales associate when you're ready to make a purchase. Just tell them how much you enjoyed this video and that guy presenting should be making feature films. Actually, just mention the video. The right server ear has the power on button, a USB 2.0 port next to a VGA port, and micro AB USB port. The left control panel has the system health and system ID indicator, and to the right of that, a few status indicator LEDs, including drives, temperature, electrical, memory, and PCIe. Additional chassis management options include QuickSync 2.0, which uses the OpenManage mobile app. The OpenManage mobile app can be used with a smartphone or tablet and is compatible with iOS or Android operating systems. The optional bezel with optional LCD panel can also provide system information, status, and error messages, but can also be used to configure or view the iDRAC IP address for the system. The iDRAC port on the back provides remote access to the system. The port on the front also enables a crash cart with monitor, keyboard, and mouse to quickly address iDRAC for at-chassis management of the system. I'm hopeful we have our iDRAC video up soon so you can see some of the features. If it is, then there should be a link right there. iDRAC with Lifecycle Controller helps keep the system up to date and can also be used to install the OS, configure, maintain, and diagnose. This platform can also use Dell's OpenManage portfolio to manage the system in physical, virtual, local, and remote environments, inbound or out of band. It also provides one-to-many management for Dell PowerEdge servers and can integrate with other third-party consoles like Microsoft System Center, VMware Center, Ansible Modules, and ServiceNow. That last one seems like it could be useful at restaurants and fast food places. ServiceNow! It will also connect with Miro Focus and other HPE tools, plus IBM Tivoli and Nagios Core. On the back of the server, there's a row of either four hot plug 2400-watt platinum or 2800-watt titanium redundant or mixed node PSUs. Depending on how the system is configured, there are three redundancy policies: not redundant, PSU redundant, and AB grid redundant. In a nutshell, that last feature takes two PSUs, say one and three, and places them in grid A, two and four in grid B, and if one of the PSUs fails in grid A, grid B takes over. Just redundancy of a different kind. This system also has a hot spare feature to reduce the power overhead. Above those are two 1 gigabit Ethernet NIC ports embedded on the LOM card. That LOM card is also removable and is connected to the motherboard. Then an optional OCP 3.0 card slot offering a number of options for port connections and link speeds, depending on your choice. Next, the ID button with integrated LED, an MLAN port to access iDRAC for remote management of the system, two USB ports with 2.0 port on top and a USB 3.0 port on the bottom, and a VGA port to connect a monitor. Above all of that, the PCI slot covers and a weird handle thing that is just to support rigidity in the case. As this system will be quite heavy when loaded up, there are two handles on each side of the chassis. With the cover removed, you can see several risers in back, risers 1 and 3 and 4 on top, and risers 2 placed under riser 3 in the middle. There are either 3x16 PCI 4.0 slots or two PCI 4.0x16 slots plus 2x8 slots. Those PCI slots can be used to support additional high-speed I/O devices. They can also be outfitted with a PCI-based bus card with dual M.2 NVMe drives to boot the system, or a PERC or PowerEdge RAID controller card like the H745 or H755. A row of 6 internal fans pulls cool air from the front of the server and directs it over the CPU's memory modules and then over the PCIe slots and out the back of the server. That bank of fans can be removed as a single unit, or individual fans can be pulled and replaced if need be. A plastic air shroud, when removed, exposes the CPUs and memory modules. Under the mid-cover is the GPU air shroud, which covers the GPUs and NVLink board in the lower portion of the chassis. Under the panel is the NVLink board with support for 4 A100 SXM4 GPUs. Those are kept cool by that plastic cover, which directs the fresh air from the bank of 12 fans on the front through some tall heat sinks. You can see the backplane for the system drives with various connectors, including a few PCIe NVMe connectors, which in turn are cabled to the system board for drive support. That backplane is also easily removable without tools. Featuring Zen 3 architecture and up to 64 cores, the third generation AMD EPYC processors feature a system-on-chip design with integrated I/O controllers. They also support 8 memory channels each. Two memory modules can be installed per memory channel for a larger memory footprint, but memory speeds will be reduced. With each 8-core chiplet sharing 32 megabytes of L3 cache, the CPUs can have up to 256 megabytes of L3 cache, plus up to 4.1 gigahertz turbo. This chassis will support CPUs with a thermal design power rating of up to 280 watts. Memory speeds are variable depending on a number of factors. Only DDR4 modules are supported in capacities of 32 gigabyte and 64 gigabyte for up to 2 terabytes of memory, with all 32 DIMM slots loaded with 64 gigabyte memory modules. The documentation also says up to 256 gigabytes per memory channel, which would provide up to 4 terabytes of memory at capacity. Yeah. There's usually something that drives me insane about these reference materials. The processors in this chassis get a little, well, a lot of help from the 4 NVMe SXM4 A100 Tensor Core GPUs, as this system is NVIDIA certified. These GPUs feature Ampere architecture and can cover a large range of processing needs for highly parallel workloads like machine learning and AI inference, not to mention virtualized workloads with the MIG or multi-instance GPU feature. With MIG, they can be partitioned into 7 isolated GPU instances. They offer a 20 times improvement over the performance of just the previous generation Volta-based GPUs. The 80 gigabyte version offers the world's fastest memory bandwidth at over 2 terabytes per second, or at least did, depending on when you're actually viewing this video. Keep in mind, some of our videos have been up for like 10 years. The GPUs are installed on an NVIDIA NVLink board offering GPU to GPU communication speeds of up to 600 gigabytes per second. That is significantly less than the 2 terabytes per second bandwidth they are capable of. I think that 2 terabyte memory bandwidth is just the GPU having an internal conversation from its tensor cores to the GPU memory before it arrives at some conclusion and spits it out. Choose from either the NVIDIA 400 watt A100 40 gigabyte GPUs or NVIDIA 500 watt A100 80 gigabyte GPUs. 400 watt is the standard configuration, but with a custom thermal solution like this baby has, you're good to go at up to 500 watts. That said, with the 500 watt GPUs installed, the system will also have a thermal warning at 28 degrees Celsius instead of the normal 38 degrees Celsius to prevent thermal damage to the system. For high performance computing, AI, AI inference and machine learning applications, the Dell EMC PowerEdge XE8545 GPU server delivers oodles of performance. It seems like just about every server today addresses AI in some way or another, but this one is designed to hit it in a big way with 4 SXM4 A100 GPUs. And with dual third generation AMD EPYC CPUs, you can throw up to 128 cores of processing power at your workloads and expect results quickly. If you have any questions about this system or any other, post them in the comment section below. We are an authorized partner with Dell Technologies and an elite partner with NVIDIA. ITCreations.com, Until next time, I'm Doug Stuman with IT Creations, and thanks for watching. Oh, and on your way out, hit that subscribe button.